falling in love. Now, it's happened to most of us once or twice or maybe more, and not just with people. Our first story is a love affair with a beautiful, custom-made, big bragging rights guitar. But like all big romances, there's been some heartbreak along the way. Jordan with a tale of unrequited love. And just so you know, she's maskless because this was filmed pre-lockdown.
Oh, you always feel good when you're playing. Yeah, it gives you a real buzz.
The venue, a Nelson tool shed. The musician, Russ Mattson, master guitar maker. The audience, just us and these beauties. The reason, well, we'll get to that in a moment. As long as his hands are on a guitar, Russ is one happy man. Whether it's playing or building one.
I feel like it's a privileged sort of a job to be doing, you know, building instruments for people and then they go out there and create music with them.
But this story isn't about Russ at all. It's actually about the specific type of guitar he makes.
I make standard resonator guitars and I also make Weisenborn instruments.
The Weisenborn is the reason we're talking to another guitar fanatic, Bruce Cappin.
I'm a musician and music producer, engineer.
Bruce lives in the States and he's a pretty big deal.
I've recorded with Sheryl Crow, REM, Chris Isaak.
A few years ago, Bruce fell in love with the illustrious Weisenborn, so bought a vintage model in 2010, but it needed some fixing.
I went looking on the internet for someone who could repair that instrument. And I found Tony Francis in New Zealand.
Tony Francis is a Kiwi luthier who's famous in the Weisenborn world, here and abroad. This is Tony in an online forum in June.
Weisenborn was sort of through my childhood, but without me really being aware of it. I think when I figured out what the instrument was, I wanted to get one.
The Waikanae man got a name for himself in his early 20s when singer Ben Harper played one of his guitars at a concert.
He was fast in reply. He did a beautiful job on the instrument, and I was just incredibly comfortable dealing with him.
After such an enjoyable experience getting Tony to fix his first Weisenborn guitar, Bruce made the decision to order another custom-made instrument from Tony.
He asked me to wire $1,900 to him as a deposit to start on the instrument. A few months into having wired the money, I contacted him and just inquired as to how things were going. And he replied back and he said, yeah, you know, this takes a while. It's going to be at least a few months.
Bruce accepted the guitar would take some time, but his order was in 2015. Yes, 2015, as in 6 years ago. Between then and now, things have hit a sour note.
No money, no instrument. 5.5 years later, and, you know, it's a little frustrating. I've asked him repeatedly for, just give me a snapshot.
You haven't received a single photo?
No.
Not one?
Not one. I finally just got tired of the whole parade and just said, I want my money back. He told me that he was about to go on a fishing trip and to give him until the 28th of March to get back in touch.
It's now August. That deposit, around 2,700 New Zealand dollars, still hasn't hit Bruce's account, and he's not alone. We've spoken to other people here and overseas who have also had dealings with Tony. They're unhappy with his service, but Tony says all his customers understand how he works.
Not so. French musos Jean-Francois and Jonathan both spent thousands on Tony's guitars in 2015. Both waited over 2 years and both threatened legal action to finally get their guitars. Jonathan's was unfinished and had to be completed by another luthier, but Tony told us he reached happy settlements with both.
I have a very long wait list for my guitars. My client list is very well known and I do not believe I deserve to be part of what is essentially throwing someone to the dog.
5 years really, to not give a guitar or a refund. Does that sit well with you?
The waitlist is a difficult thing because it's like I build these instruments which take hundreds of hours to complete. I believe that that is communicated with the client as much as possible, and some people accept that and some people don't. And so Bruce, for example, is one of those people that doesn't accept that.
okay, I'm not alone here. And if there are other people who have suffered this same fate, then fair is fair. I have to stand up.
Why is it taking so long?
Why does it take so long? It's because, well, when people order a guitar, they charge a deposit to cover the build process. And if people cancel that, I still have guitars that are half booked. People don't know. Bruce no longer wants his guitar.
No, let's be clear. Bruce did want his guitar. He just didn't want to wait 5 years for it, and rightly so.
He may be within inches of finishing it, but he hasn't made any effort whatsoever to prove that to me.
Do you think that's fair enough from Bruce?
Do I think it's fair? Well, do you think it's fair to order an instrument from someone and then change your mind and then expect a refund straight away? Obviously, everyone that has an order will get their guitar with a refund. It's a matter of fact.
And just like that, a week after our phone call with Tony, the money appeared in Bruce's account, every last dollar.
Very surprising and amazing. I'm completely in your debt. I mean, it's almost incomprehensible that you were able to get that done.
In a statement, Tony told Fair Go,
I'm a perfectionist, and I don't compromise the quality of the work for speed. This can sometimes mean that the work takes longer than expected, in some cases, much longer. Unfortunately, on top of this, I have experienced major health problems in recent years that left me unable to work for an extended period of time.
As for his other customers,
I have reached out this week to all of those who have orders in. I've confirmed to them that I do have the capacity to fill in all of my current orders, and I'm really excited to continue this work.
I don't know if I'd go so far as to call it justice, but it's at least in pursuit of fairness. I guess that's why your show is called Fair Go, eh?
Mihardo, that is such a great result. Thrilled for Bruce. Look, we should note that it is completely understandable to have to wait for something as long as you know how long. When a year turns into 4 or 5 or 6, that's not okay.